now invite Mr. Mathivathanan to share his Puri experience, but also the aspiration of Orissa and how, what was your journey like as a keynote speaker, sir? Over to you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for the wonderful, very informative opening remarks. Let me share my presentation. My presentation has two parts, sir. Is it visible?
Very much audible.
My presentation has two parts. One is I'll talk about the journey Odisha has taken up from the year 2016-17 on the drinking water sector and the culmination of it, the drink from tap. We don't call it as a continuous water supply or 24/7 uninterrupted supply. Our mission is drink from tap, sir. It's quite different from 24/7. 24/7 per se does not guarantee quality. 24/7 as such is available for the affluent and the people who can buy water even now. In every city, 24/7 is there, but it's a private arrangement. In an affordable housing complex, people procure water by tanker and fill up their tanks and provide 24/7 supply. So they don't depend upon the water supply authorities for providing the 24/7. They have their own arrangement. But as such, there is 24/7 in many cities, depending upon the affordability. So we don't call it as a 24/7, we call it drink from tap, irrespective of the source of supply, whether you will be able to drink when you open the tap or not. It has 24/7 inherent in it. 24/7 continuous water supply is one of the components of this. Otherwise, this is a much larger mission. So I'm grateful to Professor Chari for the kind words he has given on our efforts and Odisha. This is the advertisement we brought out, and the state was proud to announce that Puri has become the first city in the country to provide drink from tap quality, IS 10,500 quality water, continuous supply 24/7. And by achieving that, we also have achieved all houses connected with, provided with house connection, 100%, 32,000 houses. All houses are metered, and all metered or billed, served, revenue collection is 100%. That's it. These are the unique things of Puri. And our Puri water supply system is that IoT-based smart water management we have implemented. And apart from Puri, much before Puri, Bhubaneswar has become the first million plus city in the entire country to achieve 100% house connections. That was we declared on 13th October 2020, almost a year ago. And along with Bhubaneswar, we have 15 other towns in Odisha which have achieved 100% house connections out of 114 cities. Puri is the latest one. The questions before us would be, what is DFT, drink from tap? Why, how, when, where? All these questions would come. What it took for us to reach here? The entire experience from 2016-17, how much efforts required to reach here? How much investments required? How did we mobilize funds? How the many cities will have this, their existing personnel are unable or struggling to manage the existing systems. How do we venture to add infrastructure and aspire for 24/7 or drink from tap? How do we achieve that scale? And the various constraints in executing it, including the contractors' availability, their technical know-how, their capacity, whether the Puri experience or partly in Bhubaneswar also we have done that, whether this experience, this success is a doable, replicable, possible for other states, other cities. I'm hopeful in the presentation, I intend to cover all these points. As Professor Chari, shown in his presentation, we also had all these, experienced all these things not long ago in 16-17. Till 16-17, we experienced we also faced issues relating to supply of water. That problem becomes very acute during summer, and the road blockades, the people manhandling the PHU officials, this issue getting raised in the assembly, adjournment motion, newspapers, nasty reports, TV reports, all these things are very, were very common to us. There were also issues relating to the water quality due to waterborne diseases, jaundice, incidences of jaundice, diarrhea, several people dying in the hospitals. If you see the status in 2016-17, the state, only 40% of the entire state was covered with the network, pipe network, remaining 60% almost was fed only by the hand pump tube well or the syntax tank served by the tankers. And per capita supply on an average was only about 60 as against your Jain Uniyaram aspiration level of 135 LPCD. And there was shortage in supply also. There are more than 100 MLD was the shortage. And there were gross inequalities in the state also. Some cities were getting excess water like Bhubaneswar, Sambalpur, Rourkela, getting much more than the 350. Bhubaneswar, we were supplying 350 LPCD. Whereas on the left-hand side, if you see this towns like Belpahad, Hindwal, Damnagar, they were getting 10, 11, 12, 13 kind of thing, LPCD. And even within the city also, there was gross inequity. Some areas, especially the low-income settlements, slums, were not getting they were not having the pipe network, they were not getting the water supply. And some other areas were getting much more than that. So inequity within the city as well as across the cities in the state. So that was in 2015, we thought that there was a policy of Odisha, urban water policy of 2013, which envisaged three-phase development, targeting 2027 to be the target date for providing 100% network coverage, quality water, all those things. We thought that 2027, we were re-examining this in 2015. We thought that 2027 is too long. That was the time we were implementing Smart City Mission and Amrut. Under Amrut, we gave priority for the drinking water supply on saturation mode. Wherever we implement, we need to provide house connection to every household. Whereas under Smart City Mission, even within the ABD area, we were not targeting to provide 100% tap connection to every household. That was the time when we thought that when under Amrut, if you are taking care of the Amrut towns, which are only 9 in Odisha, 500 in the entire country, which is only 10% or 11% of the entire, if you take all cities in the country out of 4,500, you have only 500 Amrut cities, which constitute about 11%. 90% of the cities are non-Amrut. If you are doing only in Amrut towns, who will take care of this in the non-Amrut? So state, there was a need that state has to come up with a mission on par with Amrut to provide tap water connection to every household. With that ambition, our Honorable Chief Minister Mr. Naveen Patnaik in 2017, 20th October, launched the scheme called Vasudha with 555 projects launching on the first date. So initially, if you see before 2016-17, we were getting about 100 to 200 crore per annum as the investment in drinking water sector. When we implemented Vasudha scheme, mission for providing universal coverage of tap water supply to every household in the state, then we calculated that the requirement would be about 3,800. State has been kind enough to give topmost priority for the water. Whatever amount we requested, the state was willing to give. We earmarked about a three-year implementation period. And we invest the funds we mobilized through various sources, leveraging various, including the CSR, mineral bearing fund, DMF, all Amrut, state plan, everything. About 928 projects have been launched and we started implementing this. During the implement, we took a lot of policy measures. We can say that reform measures, which are very vital to the water sector, the improvement in the water sector. We made this point very clear that every citizen has a right to tap water. If it is an urban area, then we should not talk about hand pump tube well or syntax tank. Every house should have a tap water. This is the foremost thing that we did. Next thing is that we said no to hand pumps public stand post. If every house has a tap connection, why should we have a stand post? Why there is a need for a hand pump? We said, no, we will not sanction. You ask for tap connection, we will provide. We will cover entire state, but we will not provide hand pump or anything. Then we found that there are hurdles in getting house connection by way of documentation, by way of lots of things we introduced. The policy was not to encourage taking house connection. It was discouraging the house connection. We repel people. So all those things are analyzed, and then we completely rewritten the whole policy measures to encourage people to take house connection. All things have been relaxed. We have waived the connection fee. Easy installment introduced 100 rupees per month for the non-poor. For poor, it is completely free connection. And then earlier, the water work rule says that individual house connection is a private's responsibility, household responsibility. That we changed because that we realized that the house connection is the potential contamination point. If you leave that responsibility to the individual household, they will deploy the cheapest material, the low cost material. They deploy low cost contractor workman to execute the work. And the result is that you get a low workmanship, the pipeline, pipe connection. Every such connection would act as a potential contamination point. So we realized that and then rewrote the policy to change it. We said that individual household connection is for government work. It's government's responsibility. It will be executed at government's cost. Then earlier, the individuals were supposed to get municipal permission from the municipality. They have to get road cutting permission. They have to pay 10,000 to 15,000 rupees towards road cutting fee from the municipality. All those things have been exempted. Entire responsibility was taken over by the government. And for all these 982 projects, we gave composite administrative approval, cutting the bureaucratic process delay. One single order for 555 projects in one day. That's how we cut the time taken. Then we involved the women self-help group of the locality. We executed all these 900 odd projects in 4 year time. By 2021, we enhanced the infrastructure in a massive way. 260 MLD supply has been increased. 31 water treatment plants with 260 MLD capacity have been added. 629 ESRGSR have been added. More than 6,000 kilometers of new pipe network have been added to the system. By that, 49 urban local bodies have moved from water deficient to water sufficient. You will find from the pie chart that all the reds have disappeared in a period of 4 years. So along with the quantity, along with the enhancing the infrastructure, we also focused on the quality, water quality. So in the government system, you are aware that our laboratories would be age old. The equipment, the machineries, all those things would have been procured long back with no maintenance, no trained manpower, and those capacity also would not have been trained in the meanwhile. So what we decided that won't match with the speed. It can't cater to the changing requirements. So we decided to go for setting up state of art of the water quality testing laboratory on PPP mode, and we established 9 state of art PPP labs, including Puri, in the year 2017-18. This is the first of its kind. We also have taken another very important initiative called Jalsati. Jalsatis are our women self-help group members chosen to be part of our water supply program. They manage the water distribution at the ward level. They act as a bridge between the water supply authorities, PHO, and the consumers. And they are entrusted with the responsibility of meter reading, bill generation, collecting the water charges using MPOS machine. They all have been provided with a mobile point of sale machine. And they also facilitate new connection, regularize illegal connections in their locality. And they are from the community, from that locality. And they also facilitate the complaint redressal by the PHO authorities. And they also conduct field quality testing. They have been trained. They have been provided with a field quality testing kit. All those, all of them carry that. So for every activity, they are paid an incentive. It's performance linked incentive basis. We have engaged so far about 400 Jalsatis in the entire state. In Puri, all the wards have. So by doing all these things, by enhancing the infrastructure, network, the involvement of the Jalsati, and relaxing all these norms, the last mile connectivity is actually achieving the household connection by the individual households. We started our journey in 2014-15 with just 3.1 lakh connections. And by now, we have reached about 8.89 lakh connections. We have a target of reaching 12.17 lakh connections, which we are hopeful of achieving by December 2022, whereby by the time we would have saturated the entire state, achieving universal coverage of tap water supply to every household, in every street, every ward, in every city. So that was in, it was in October 13th, we declared Bhubaneswar as the first million plus city in the country to achieve 100%. Along with that, as I said, another 15 towns have reached. We have 12.1 lakh to reach. So we also take up metering. We have, in fact, the Finance Commission grants specify metering as one of the conditions, and they provide fund for it. It was there in the fourth State Finance Commission also. We said we will not implement metering because we have not provided tap connection. We have not taken care of the quality and quantity. Without that, providing metering would be unfair. We will not have public acceptability. We did not do metering for the past 4 years. We started metering only from the last year. We said once we reach a satisfactory level of providing water in terms of quantity and quality, then we will have a moral right to put up a meter, read it, and then collect the bill. That was our stand. So we after achieving substantial level, covering more than 90% of the state, then we took up the metering, and we have taken up the metering program in all major corporation. 3 lakh households are targeted. So far, we have achieved in the last 1 year, in spite of COVID times, we have achieved 1.2 lakh metering, including part of Bhubaneswar and the entire city of Puri. And we don't face any much problem in doing the water metering. So what all these things have resulted in? What impacts? We know that it gives huge health benefit, but what is the evidence? Do we have empirical data to say that? So this is the empirical data which I want to show to Professor Chari, that this is the thing we collected from Integrated Disease Surveillance Program of Odisha. This is under the Directorate of Health and Family Welfare, Department of Health and Family Welfare, Government of Odisha. These are the data collected from their hospitals throughout the state. So you can see in 2014, these two charts give the incidences of jaundice as well as diarrhea. There were 3,608 incidences of jaundice, resulting in 29 deaths, fatalities. See where we have reached over the years. If take diarrhea also, diarrhea outbreaks, there were 3,832 incidences with 30 people died in 2016, where we have reached. It is zero in 2020. So that is the kind of impact, that is the kind of economic benefits the investment on water can have. This is the point we want to underline. So having reached this stage of providing tap water connection to more than 90% of the population, we are nearing 100%. We thought in 2019, where do we go from here? Are we going to stop with that? So far we have achieved on quantity. What about the quality? We can always say that it is clean, safe, but who will agree to that? Anybody can contradict that. So we can say that no public authority, water supply authority will say that they are supplying contaminated water. Everybody says that we are providing safe and clean, but can we guarantee that at the consumer end? At the treatment point, everybody can say that it is a clean water, safe water. But can we give that kind of the same guarantee at the consumer end? Can't we give that? Why not we try that? Because in the entire pipe network belongs to us. It doesn't belong to the public. It is our responsibility. Since it is our network, it is our, we have to transport the water. At the consumer end, can we guarantee this? That was the thought which went behind this Drink from Tap mission. when you open the, as when we go to abroad, developed countries, US, Europe, the moment you get out of the airport, you can drink the water from the tap. Whereas here we can't do it. None of us can do it. The chief engineer, engineer in chief cannot drink water from the tap. Who is supplying? Nobody has the guts. So can we do that? Can we assure to the water quality? That was the thought process behind this. We thought that we must achieve that. Then we found out that it is the IS 10500 which provides the quality norms. So we said that, well, let us go with the Bureau of Indian Standards, IS 10500, let us meet all the 30 parameters, quality parameters. So that was the genesis of this thing from tap mission. We started on a pilot basis. The first pilot we have taken a slum in Bhuvaneshwar. It is called Ishaneshwar Basti. Because we are very clear that the most deserving people are the slum people, the working class. It matters a lot to them, not for others. So this program has to be implemented in a slum. If we can implement this in a slum, then this can be upscaled and implemented in the entire state. We took 12 pilot zones in Pune, Bhuvaneshwar, as well as Puri, covering about 1.8 lakh population. And along with that, we started with the Ishaneshwar Basti with about 450 household. It was a success. Then only we took other zones on pilot basis. In that 12 zones, we have also included Salia Sahi, which is the largest slum in the state of Odisha. It is in Bhuvaneshwar. It is in the heart of Bhuvaneshwar. It has 57,500 population. That was one of the pilot zones we took. And we took representative areas, residential, mixed, commercial, residential, institutional, all areas we have taken. And then on October 13th, 2020, Honorable Chief Minister dedicated all the pilot zones successful. Then only we launched it. We also had our own, you know, fear. We also had the fear whether this continuous water supply is possible or not. Because we are aspiring much beyond that. We are aspiring drink from tap, guaranteeing water quality, highest standard quality at the consumer end. So whether we can live to our expectation, whether it is the dream can be realized or not, we had lots of doubts. Thanks to my team, I have my managing director, VATCO, Mr. P.K. Swani here, and other senior officers are also attending this webinar. Thanks to my committed, passionate, the driven, the high energy team, they said that we can do it, sir. So they have done it. They demonstrated, and then we did the trial, waited for some time, just waiting for any you know disaster to happen. So after that, once we were clear that our path was pakka, it was solid, and this is the route. Then we declared, and then Honorable Chief Minister to dedicate his dream mission, which we did on October 13th, 2020. Then we took up upscaling in Bhuvaneshwar and Puri, and the implementation work has started in October 2020 in Puri and Bhuvaneshwar. We took up that DMA planning made. 19 DMAs were created in Puri. All the infrastructures are all age old. We never know. We don't have any records, nothing, no documentation. We are extremely weak in it. I'm sure everywhere it's similar to that. So we had to take up the infrastructure conditions assessment. Then we took up the gap closing in the network. Then, as I said, that since we realized that house connections are the potential contamination points, we went for 100% replacement of the house connections, 100% metering. And we have also a real-time smart water management system we have implemented. And all critical assets we provided with power backup, isolation valves, everything. And we took up real-time quality surveillance, monitoring, and intervention. It's all automatic intervention. And as I said, we developed the smart water management system for covering the entire city. So one of the very important thing is that all the critical assets and consumers have been mapped on GIS platform, and those informations have been used on real-time basis to analyze the operation and maintenance, operation and management of the system. Also, that is also used to analyze the maintenance requirement of the water supply assets from time to time. So several measures we have taken up as part of the Drink from Tap missions, the lab on wheels, wherever we get complaints about the quality, our lab on wheel will reach there in a few minutes. And then we do the preliminary quality test in the field itself. We also have quick response teams, which are mobilized on short call. We have a 24/7 customer care center, which receives the complaints and directs to various teams position. And we also, along with that, we also take up this campaign, public awareness campaign. We can say that our water is pure, quality is assured, but public has to buy that. They have to believe in it. How do we create the public trust? Because in here, we can buy a water bottle, mineral water bottle. We can buy a water pouch and drink it. Whether it is branded or not branded, we believe in private. But when it comes to government, public water supply authorities, we don't believe. We don't trust the quality because we have legacy issues. So we have never created that kind of confidence in the minds of the public. That's the reason public don't believe us. So we thought that we have to create that confidence in the minds of the public. So we took up an extensive campaign to create the public awareness, to build that public trust and confidence on the water quality we are providing, quality. So we have taken up this campaign called Pure for Sure. And real-time water quality parameters are displayed in the public domain, in important junctions, places where public footfall is high. We put up this LED display system where real-time quality parameters are displayed. This is one of the pilot zone, Kalinganagar. VATCO 24/7 water supply, Kalinganagar, date, time. On 9/9/2020, 14/13, this is the, these are the parameters. That is the current parameter. It's not old. So that is, these are the efforts. Mapping of all the assets and consumers on GIS platform. And measuring the water, the flow, the pressure at every critical places. Almost at every 150-200 meters, we have IoT devices, and which gives continuous data. Every 5 seconds, we get the information. And we have a command and control center with video wall, visually seeing the assets and their conditions and the functioning. And 126 terminal devices, as I said, and sensors have been deployed throughout the city. And any incidents, any burst or any leakages, we will get this display. We can immediately notice that. We can rush our team to address that, to resolve that issue. The incidents management is enabled by this smart water management dashboards. And it is not that our engineers have to be sitting in the control room. They can be anywhere, mobile. And this smart water management application is mobile-based, mobile-enabled. From anywhere, they can access this. They can even operate the pump and the chlorine doser from remotely using the mobile also. And this has helped tremendously in reducing the water leakages, incidents management. And you'll be happy to know that our non-revenue water has reduced from 54% before when we started the program to 15% currently because of the timely identifying the issues and resolving those issues. And the technology is our backbone. With that, we are able to, not only that, we also get the confidence. Public also get the confidence and the response is instant. And we have deployed, as I said, that large scale citywide deployment of industrial IoT in this smart water management system. So for this smart water management system, we also have got 2 national awards. And not only in Puri, not only in pilot zones of Bhubaneswar, this Drink from Tap is upscaled to another 17 cities, including Bhubaneswar. The contracts have already been awarded and the design is in progress. And we have a target of completing in all these 17 cities, which would benefit more than 50 lakh population. That means out of 70 lakh population, 50 lakh population would get Drink from Tap before 2nd October 2023. That's our target. So this has been our journey from 2016 onwards, culminating in Drink from Tap. With this, I stop my presentation and.